The White House continues to receive pressure on the escalating supply chain backlogs.
There's a lot of talk about Christmas presents not arriving on time, but the issue is more severe and critical than that. I mean, it's affecting small businesses. Auto body shops can't get parts to fix cars, so they can't make money. 90% of school nutrition programs say they're worried about continued supply chain issues, according to a School Nutrition Association survey. Some schools are making last-minute grocery store trips just to feed their students. So if this is an issue that the White House has been working on and aware of since February, why does it seem like this is a problem that is getting worse, not better?
I would say this. When it comes to the supply chain, there are complexities there.
We have new Hill-HarrisX data on President Biden's approval on supply chain management. So let's take a look at that.
Would you consider the National Guard to help with the supply chain issue?
Yes, absolutely, positively, I would do that. But in addition to that, what you gotta do is you gotta get these ships in and unloaded. I wanna get the ports up and running and get the railroads and the railheads and the trucks in port ready to move, because I've gotten Walmart and others to say, we're gonna move stuff off of the port into our warehouses.
You're actually talking about having National Guardsmen or women driving trucks?
The answer is yes, if we can't move to increase the number of truckers, which we're in the process of doing.
The poll found 46% of voters disapprove of the president's handling of the country's supply chain problems, while 32% approve and 22% said neither. 64% of Democrats approve of Biden's handling of the issue, while 79% of Republicans and 54% of independents disapprove. So what do you think about that, Ryan?
I like this, the question of, you've been working on this since February, yet the supply chains are still broken. it's a problem 30 years in the making.
Right.
Why haven't you snapped your fingers and fixed the global supply chains? On the other hand, there's plenty of criticism that you can level for, and also you have to criticize the president, because the president is the one who has the ability not to snap your finger and fix the supply chain, but to put pressure in the direction that will eventually lead it to get fixed. It's not happening anytime soon.
No.
What's he going to do about ports in Vietnam or Hong Kong, or what, what's he going to do about shipping containers that are stuck at African ports, by snapping his finger? At the same time, you also have the transportation secretary who's been out on leave for a very long time. I'm pro paternity leave.
Right. we're not going that direction.
But I mean, I hope he's on calls and Zooms, because you can do that while you're walking around the neighborhood pushing the baby in the stroller, or while the baby's napping. If you're asking workers, to start doing 24/7 shifts in Long Beach, then I think the transportation secretary can. Zoom while the baby's napping.
Didn't Mayor Pete have a documentary coming out or something too? I'm pretty sure.
Well,
that
was probably filmed a while ago.
Yeah.
Right. How many memoirs has he done? I bet he'll compete with Obama for a number of memoirs before a certain
Profiles of Audacity and Courage. Great free title advice for you.
But I don't know what do you make of this? You said you were going to fix the supply chain, but it's not fixed yet.
Yeah, obviously that's dumb, because it takes a while. But and you and I probably disagree on that. Like, we can't just bring all the manufacturing back to the country, as much as that's a fantasy. That can't happen because we have regulations, we have rules on how long people can work and what they get paid and all that stuff that progressives support, Democrat support, many Republican support. So you're not going to undo any of that stuff, which means like companies will always offshore their manufacturing.
Right. We can't bring it all back, but we can bring some of it back. And also we can
if there are regulatory, and I'm for getting rid of these regulatory burdens, but barriers to doing that. But it's there's not a lot of political will
although
for
it's
that.
It's not normally regulatory burdens. The John Deere is threatening to shut down some of its Iowa plants and move those companies overseas, move that production overseas, not because of any regulatory burdens, but because the workers are striking for higher wages. So it's simple for them. They want to find workers that they can exploit more surplus value out of.
Meanwhile, Federalist writer Jordan Davidson argues that the media wants to blame Americans' shopping habits on the supply chain disaster rather than the Biden administration's handling of the situation, calling out headlines such as this one from The Atlantic. Supply chain problems could be solved more quickly if affluent Americans would stop buying up things they don't need and often don't even really want. And yeah, I agree with Jordan that that's a really stupid way to to characterize
supply
this.
Supply side solution.
Yeah. Stop buying. I don't know. I mean, I'm one of the people being called out here. I order everything I could ever need on Amazon. Probably more junk than I need, but it's I don't think my shopping habits are causing this supply. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe that's what's exhausting it.
I mean, any effort to solve a structural problem by encouraging consumers to behave slightly differently is going to fail.
Right.
That you're not going to solve.
The environmental movement has showed us a lot of that. Take slightly colder showers. Yeah, sure. Right. And, not going to happen.
And it's just like with the environmental stuff, it's fine. It just can't be a substitute. Is lowering your thermostat good? Yes. You know, is getting solar panels good? You know, eventually it adds up to structural solutions. Is composting good? Yes. Is recycling good? Maybe.
Sort of. Very dubious, right?
Whether not so sure about
recycling
that one.
Is, we should do a conversation on that one. It looks kind of like a scam.
Recycling probably not. But reducing your own waste.
Yeah.
Sure. Like not buying as much stuff. Is that good? That's probably good spiritually. Mm-hmm. But is that going to solve the supply chain crisis? No.
And is turning
down your thermostat going to solve the climate crisis? No. Doesn't mean you shouldn't do it, but you need to do more.
Yeah. More rising after this. Stay with us.